got my bucket, my spade, my stick of rock, but it's flipping freezing. I don't know where the sea's gone, and it's not very peaceful.
Hundreds of people have joined me at Weston for Great Britain's one and only sand race. Once a year, when the tide goes out, the cars come in, the usual 15 miles an hour speed limit is lifted, and a 1 mile racetrack appears. Salt and sand attacking your car at 100 miles an hour doesn't do it a lot of good. So why do they do it?
Every year I enjoy it. It's usually good weather. This year it's been a bit cold, but I always enjoy it.
Camaraderie, nice people, and it's a lovely venue. It's different.
If you can imagine driving on a bed of marbles, that's about the nearest description you can get to it. The thing is to go quickly down the straight, set up, and keep neat for the corners.
But if you don't, at least there are no trees to hit. Sand racing seems popular, but now it's only held in the Channel Islands and here at Weston.
The tide's still out, but I'm determined to enjoy myself here on the beach with Rambo, but I don't really think that he's fully up to it, so it's a good job that I've brought my RAC competition licence, my overalls and my helmet. Come on, Rambo, let's go and look for a car.
In the end, I was kindly loaned a more suitable form of transport. It's called an Opel Manta.
And it's a charge to the first bend now as we come straight down this 100-yard straight. And then it's a hard right-hander and we're absolutely neck and neck here. I've been told to keep out of the ruts and also to not get behind the cars that are throwing up too much sand. One of the problems is the sand comes up and gets into the radiator. This is really bad news. In fact, we'd have to pull out of the event.
I'm having to learn pretty fast. You don't get much chance to practice this sand racing lark. But Barney Paul Edwards knows the score.
The surface looks like even sand, but in fact you get changes in texture, and as people who drive in the desert will tell you, it can look the same, but you suddenly get a tremendous amount of grip or no grip, so you have to balance the car. It is something that most people pick up fairly quickly.
Well, Barney certainly appears to have the hang of it in his rally car. The autocross specials are the ones to watch. Mike Turpin won this, and every other event is entered in his overgrown roller skate.
I normally do the Santa Cross every year. I've done it for quite a number of years now. It's a 2-litre BDA engine in it, with just a 2-speed Hewland gearbox. Seems to be adequate for the job, really.
It must be pretty dreadful being sitting out in the open. Don't you get sand in your eyes?
Well, not if you stay in front, you don't.
I have to spend my time at work. My job is very boring. I'm an office clerk.